Okay, now let's discuss when we first time log in. So what you will see in FortiGate firewall. So there are two way to set your FortiGate firewall dashboard. When you first time log in, it's called a dashboard. Whatever you can see, this called a dashboard. Dashboard can be a network operation central, NOC, which we call them NOC. This is the method to use them. And NOC, what do you know, and SOC and NOC. Where you can see security operation center and network operation center, they want to monitor network devices. And normally you will see the same structure like this one. There will be many devices you can see. So that's why they give them this dashboard network operation center, a responsive layout. Responsive give you response. You can change the thing. You can move them. You can resize them. You can horizontally, you can make them fit. You can fit them vertically. You can change them. So that's why it's called responsive. It gives you response. Whatever you want, it's a flexible. So first time you will see when you open it, you will see this dashboard. This dashboard is basically divided in four categories. Those four categories are status, top usage lane DMZ, security and system event. So let me show you. So when you first time log in, on the top left corner, there is a logo of FortiGate firewall. And there is a name, FortiGate and VM, which version you are using, it will be written here. And then this the name, host name. By the way, this host name is here. You can change the host name, go to configuration setting. You can change from here as well. It will take you here. Suppose I say FortiGate 1 and apply. So now it's FortiGate 1. Either you can go to system setting, it's here, okay? And you can change them the host name from here as well. Okay, so that's the logo, then the name, and then the host name of the device. And we have a green theme. You can change the theme, which we will see later in the course. It's somewhere here. Let me go to theme, yeah, this one green. Again, in system setting, here is if you want to change, so it's another color. If you want to change them to blue, if this one anyway, it's very awkward. This one, so let me go.
Small quick question.
Yes,
when compared to Palo Alto, this FortiGate firewall is not on the same behavior, right? Whatever the things in Palo Alto, we need to give commit, but here, after changing the host name of the device. Without giving a commit, it will reflect on the box.
Yeah, yeah. In every course, you are asking this question. In LTM, you also ask the same, yeah?
Yes. Because we need to understand about the behavior.
I'm just noticed, but it's good question. Yeah, I was about to tell you. And it's not like a FortiGate Palo Alto firewall. Whatever you do on the spot, when you click apply on save button, it will directly save. Same like a LTM, which we done in F5. Okay, so yes, whatever you do, it will be on the spot, but there is a configuration. We will see the backup and restore, but anyway, right now I will say yes. So that's the logo, the name, then host name, green theme, whatever theme you like, you can change from here the theme. Here is a search button. If you want to search something specifically, you want to go to system or something. So it will give you, told you that in system administration, you want to go setting HN, so many things. You can clear from here and you can make them as a filter as well. Here is a small greater than and then this one. This is CLI. Rather than to go to CLI there, they give you an option to open CLI here, the command line interface, CLI command line console. So you can check your thing from here as well. Suppose whatever you want to command, show system, the one which we run there, show system interface and question mark. So it's showing me the IP here. Now there is a record button if you want to record this script. So it will be recording and you can watch them later on. If you want to clear, I don't want to clear it right now because I want to download it. Okay, click on download and save. Okay, you can save this command. Maybe you run so many debug command and you want to see them. So click on this file and you can open in Notepad on Notepad++. So you will see the same command which I run here. So it's a good thing to export them as well. And copy to clipboard. Rather than to download, copy, now is copy and go to any notepad okay, and you can paste here this the same result which I download, and from here you can make them a bigger. So click, it will be detached and will open the big screen as separately. You can run all the commands separately rather than to here as a small window. Okay, and the last thing which I didn't tell you, this one to clear the screen, it will clear the screen for you. And the last, if you want to close it, so it will give you this option. This will make the screen bigger, it will remove everything which is coming here. You can bring them back as well. Okay, and you can close, so it will come back here. So it's another way to full screen. Here, if you need a help align videos, either any documentation, you can go from here. This small notification will show you whatever happened in your system, it will be showing here. Okay, so this one, so right now it's showing me only the VM evaluation license detail. The right in the corner there is the user who login, and FortiGate Visa, it was here in the corner. Okay, so this the name of the operating system we are using, version and build number, which we will see later on. System to reboot the system and shut down the system, definitely is clear to you. Configuration, we will do backup and restore. This, leave it this one. We can backup to take backup, we can restore the backup, and we can revision as well. Because if you have two version to check which version have changes, we can see this one, and also script to run. Change the password. Suppose I want to change the administrator password 123, new password 123, and new password 123, and okay. So if you want to change the password, so login back 123. Okay, so let me click on this one. Sorry, let me, okay. So this the whatever user login, it will show here. Change password, I told you, and log out if you want to log out from here and want to log in back. So this was the first part. Now coming here, this is the dashboard. Okay, and dashboard has four categories: status, top usage lane when, security, system events. It's divided in four category. And status one, the one which is selected, it will be green. If I click this one is green now. If you are using green theme, if you are using any other theme, that will be, you will understand that this one is selected. Yeah, it look like a selected. Now is this one is selected. So now let's go back to the status. Okay, so dashboard is divided in four category: status. Here it, this is called widgets. This widgets, if you click on here, you can resize this widgets as well. So now it's bigger now. And if you need, you can make them single again as well. If you need a small widget, you can remove them as well. System information. So I remove it. If you need again, there is a small button in the corner. Okay. And click on widgets. I told you it's called widgets. So which widgets I remove? System information, this one. And the system information. Click and close. So it's come up here again. But they put the system information here. It's okay, you say no, 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 I need whatever it was. So say reset dashboard and okay, it will make them back to whatever it was before, like a new one. So if you go back, if not showing, yeah, so you have to refresh. So I does a refresh, so you will see again whatever it was like before. So now it's come up. So don't worry, just play around it. Whatever you can reset them back. Okay, so system information widget showing name of the this system, serial number, firmware version. Okay, mode, we will see mode, there are 2-3 mode. System time, uptime from how long, 12 minutes pass, and when IP, because we are not using license, so it's showing me unknown. License information, virtual machine, CPU usage, and all those information, how much is used and how much is allocated RAM. FortiGate cloud related stuff, fabric related stuff, security rating, because we don't have license, again not showing. And administrator, who is login? So admin is login with HTTP, so there is a one small. But in FortiExplorer, there is nothing. FortiExplorer is a tool, utility from where you can log in as well. Just like a CLI, HTTP, so there is a FortiExplorer as well. Like a checkpoint, there is also a way. So one is written here. Again, you can maximize, resize, and you can remove. Then CPU from last 1 minute, 10 minute CPU, 30 minute CPU you want to see, and you can maximize full screen and you can resize them as well. Same as memory related, last 30 minute, 12 hour, 24 hour, maximize, and if you want to resize and remove. Session, how many session has been connected right now? If you want to see the session for 10 minute, maximize, and if you want to remove 10 minute, and there are many options up to 24. So this was the status
dashboard. So the above one, the 40 gate telemetry, is the right what it is?
Yeah, I will tell you everything. Don't worry. Just right now, I'm just telling you that in dashboard what we have. So it's divided in four category, and there is widgets. The widgets can be maximized, minimized, remove, and rename and reset. Okay. Don't worry. Everything will be clear. Now the second one, we done only one, the status one, is the top usage LAN DMZ. What does it mean by top usage? Means the top usage for the LAN and DMZ traffic. So LAN and DMZ traffic. So whatever the top things means. So top source, top destination, top application, top website, and so many things. You can add your own as well. Even you can change the name. If you click here, there is edit dashboard, okay? And change the name. Suppose I want to give them name test. Okay. And okay. Now the name will be changed to test. Okay. And anytime you say no, I just need the reset dashboard. Okay. And now it's again top usage LAN and WAN. So the top thing it will show you. And the top thing means the top source, from where top source and bytes. Again, you can change. Now resize is huge now. Okay, you can change them, not like a status one. Sitting, if you want to do something sitting like 40 view, you can change them time period. You can name them bubble chart rather than to a table view. You can check by session. Here is written top source by byte. You say no, check by session. So it's change it to session. So there is a small button to change the setting of this one. Okay, so let me take it by it. Okay, again. So top source will be shown, means the source IP and their usage. Then destination IP and there is usage and session. Then top application and top website. So whatever, whenever you need top things, top source, top destination, you have to come to top usage LAN and DMZ. It will show you like this. Because when I take a screenshot, so it was like in that time there was a traffic. So let me show if there is, yeah. So top usage, this is the IP and bytes has been used. And these are the destination, Google they visit. And these are the top application, HTTPS, ping command, and so many other things. And top website, whatever they visited. Okay. The third dashboard is security related, which you were asking. So top compromise host, which host has been compromised on your LAN, okay? Top thread by thread level, it will show you thread level application. And 40 client detect vulnerability, any vulnerability detect, which we will see later in the course, don't worry. We will access some viruses website, so it will come up here that this piece is infected. I think so, maybe when I done, so at that time there was. So let's see, yeah, no, I didn't take the screenshot in that time. So it will show you here. So these are related to security stuff, okay? And it can be 40 client, vulnerability, scanning, thread related, host verdict, anything. So, and the last one is system events related. So definitely the name suggests this dashboard will only see the events which is related to the system. Again, you can refresh them, you can maximize them, you can minimize them, and you can setting, you can change the setting, you can resize them, and you can remove. The last thing which I didn't tell you, some of the widgets, when you click OK, not right click. So they will give you some setting, like this one, setting. It will take you some setting. Some of them, it will take you like upgrade firmware setting. So rather than to go to system, which is here, and firmware here, so you can go from here as well. it will take you there. So some of them is like this to take you shortcut there. So this was the four dashboard which we discussed, four different way. So security related was this one. Okay, now if you say no, I need my own dashboard and whatever I like, I want to put that one. So it's okay. In the corner there is a small gear. Okay, click on that one. So it's a add widgets, means add widgets like this one. Suppose if you want to add an extra widgets, so the one which is grayed out is already added. Botnet activity is not added. So click on this one. It will be added. And HA status is not added. Close. So when you go down, so there will be botnet activities. And there is HA activities as well. It's added. So you can add extra widgets as well. And 40 view you can add there. And system resources related, security fabric related, you can add. So now we know in gear icon, add widgets with add widgets. Reset dashboard, I already told you it will reset and will make the default one. Add dashboard, if you want to add, instead of status, you change the name, which I show you. So you can edit them as well. Add a new dashboard, not a widgets. So if I say I need a new dashboard, my dashboard. Responsive or not wise? Responsive, it will give you a response. It's very quick and every operating system, like mobile and other, it will be changed the layout. But in NOC, it will be the same which is NOC one. Okay. So now my dashboard has been added. Where is it's here, but nothing is there. You can add whatever you like. Add widgets. I need admin, botnet, HA license, virtual machine, host scan. This one, sorry. I need to give them anything to add them. Add widgets, 40, memory usage session, whatever you like, add, and now your dashboard is ready. But this is the customized one which you require my dashboard, not the four which is the default one. And anytime you don't need, you can go and you can delete a dashboard and say, okay, I don't need. So dashboard has been deleted. Okay, so let me go if I miss something. Okay, so we see there is a system information detail, botnet, LAN detail, a disk detail, 40 top, and you can add botnet activities, log, so many things are there which we will discuss later in the course. From here, you can add new dashboard, you can edit dashboard, you can delete dashboard, you can reset, and you can add a widgets, which is different, and dashboard is a different thing. From this gear icon, we add our own one. Okay, give them anything you want and we use that one. Okay, there is more information. When you click, I told you, when you click on this one, so it will take you to the more information table. And you can see by 1 minute, 10 minute, 1 hour, 12 minute, whatever. So it will give you everyone differently.